Well, it was the painting that drew, was sort of how we all found this story. I came across it through visiting Kenwood and was astonished to see this completely ambiguous portrait, which was of this stunning white woman and this stunning black woman. And you couldn't tell, were they friends, were they sisters, was one a servant, one a visitor? It was all, as you'll see by the portrait, there's a slightly exotic clothing, one slightly in front of the other, they're touching, there's a wry smile. It was like fascinating, and I believe it's fair to say most portraits of the period do not, unless they're obviously like servants or slaves, do not feature black folk. So it was really interesting to sort of delve deeper into the portrait, and then we discovered they were both adopted and they were sisters, and it just, and the more we learned about the family history, it just became a sort of fascinating exploration of this woman's sort of journey of self-identity and discovery, and then and how the two sisters sort of, you know, grew up together, and colour and class all came into play. There was something about the sort of class and sophistication she brought to the role. You know, it's not My Fair Lady, it's not Pygmalion, because this woman, you know, this girl is raised in this household from very young, but obviously she goes through a huge journey of self-discovery about, you know, her roots, herself, and also her choices in her life. And there was just a sort of measured sophistication that I thought Gugu just nailed, that, you know, hopefully you'll see on the big screen. What drew me, it's not so much that it should be a history lesson, but just the human emotions that we portray and the dilemmas, I think are as resonant today as then. You know, we deal with colour, we deal with class, we deal with the fact this woman isn't going to be betrothed and married to anyone, and suddenly she is willed money, and then suddenly all these people who didn't want to marry her because of her colour don't mind about her colour. So I think it says a lot of interesting things about the human condition, class in this country, that is still prevalent today, and you know, as well as just being a good old-fashioned romance.